Let's talk about Raw. Oh, my favorite part of the week. There's some good wrestling on this show. So it opened up with the KO show with Alpha Academy, which was not my favorite segment on the show. It was infuriatingly annoying and it sucked. But the story is that Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins do not have a clear path to either night of WrestleMania. This show is so stupid sometimes, but I watch it. So anyway, they have no path to WrestleMania. You know, they're not going to be able to get on the card. So they got to figure out a way, and they want to become the tag team champions.
Wait a second. Just throwing this in here. There have been times where the tag team champions have not been on WrestleMania.
Don't overthink this.
Just saying.
Because if you want to overthink, let's talk about what happened next. It is Seth Rollins and Kevin Owens versus the tag team champions Alpha Academy. Seth Rollins and Kevin Owens just won. They just won a number one contenders match. But it is very specific. They will only get their championship match in a three-way next week. So even though they're the number one contenders, they've earned a shot at the tag team championships. Oh, they can't have it in this one-on-one tag team match. So Seth Rollins and Kevin Owens, as number one contenders, they face the tag team champions. They beat them, but the titles are not on the line. I was not letting Dave get away with this one, but he just kept going that this made sense. This makes no sense. They're the number one contenders. So anyway, they beat Alpha Academy. It was a good match. Very good match. Omos squashed T-Bar in 39 seconds. Then we add Bianca Belair, Rhea Ripley, and Liv Morgan versus Becky Lynch, Doudrop, and Nikki A.S.H. Another 12-minute match. By the way, those things I talked about, that was the entire first hour. So this was another good match. Everybody worked hard, and the highlight of the match, except for Becky Lynch, was when Bianca took her ponytail and she just starts whipping poor Becky Lynch. And man, I watched it. And you ever seen those old WWE shows that are taped and they edit in some goofy sound effect? Bro, she whipped her with this ponytail, and it sounded like a cannon went off in the Civil War. And I thought, oh my God. Then I realized it was live. That was the actual sound. She whipped her, as Jim Ross would say, like a government mule. And Becky's got these marks all over her body. Her skin's broke. It was brutal.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my God.
Industrial strength beeswax on
Yeah,
those,
you idiots don't like the build of this
braids.
Match again, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Dude, this was great. Then we had Ciampa beating Robert Roode quickly, 2 minutes. Listen, they're trying to get you to watch NXT by bringing NXT people and storylines to the main roster, but they give it 2 minutes. It's like, why did you even bother? Like, if you're going to do it, give me something where I'm like, man, I want to tune in tomorrow to see the tag match. And this is over. I did not feel that way. We had Dana and Reggie beating Tamina and Akira Tozawa in 1 minute. And then afterwards, remember all that those cool storylines they did with Reggie and Dana? Yeah, well, it was all for naught. They're back together again. Now they're kissing again. And now Akira Tozawa and Tamina have a romance. Because why not? Gotta attract the women viewers. We had Ray and Dominic coming out, and then Miz cut every promo he's ever cut. Did you know that Miz has won a lot of belts in his career? Huh?
Yeah.
God, can you imagine if I came on this show every day and like every day I had to talk about, you know, I wrote 2 books, actually basically 3 books. Do you know, I should start every show. How's it going, everybody? Bryan Alvarez here, Wrestling Observer Live. 3-time Wrestling Observer Book of the Year winner, best-selling author of Death of WCW, the original version, and the, whatever you call it, the longer version. Also, 100 things WWE fans should know and do before they die. In 6th grade, I won Student of the Year alongside Chris Walla of Death Cab for Cutie, which is true, by the way. And I'm the Texarkana Television Champion. I've got a black belt from Pedro Sauer, first degree, by the way. Should be second, but I haven't seen him because there's a pandemic. Anyway, now let's get moving. God, how annoying that would be. I didn't even mention my ring. Shelton Benjamin and Cedric Alexander, of course, beat Ray and Dominic. Because what better way to build up Ray and Dominic versus Miz and Logan Paul than to beat the Mysterios with a team that never wins? So that was lame. And then we had the Street Profits. Actually, first we had Queen Zelina and Carmella doing a segment where... You remember yesterday where I go, okay, we got Roman Reigns and Brock Lesnar in a unification match where the belts aren't going to be unified for very long. I'm just going to go back to what they had. We're going to have Vince McMahon wrestling, even though he's not actually going to wrestle. Well, now, Carmella and Zelina are going to retain the tag titles against Sasha Banks and Naomi. And then Carmella is going to have sex. That's what they're advertising. Buy your tickets now. That's night one if you want to see sex. Night one of WrestleMania. Street Profits versus Randy Orton and Riddle. Poor Randy Orton. Actually, I shouldn't say poor Randy Orton because I haven't heard an update today. So what happened was Montez Ford gave him the big frog splash, and Randy Orton sold it like his heart came out his neck or whatever. He's dying and everything like that. The referee's down there. Everyone's checking on the poor guy. He pretends, or I shouldn't say pretends. Let me just tell you what happened. He tries to get his foot on the rope. Montez pushes the rope off. He gets pinned. He's, you know, they're all checking on the guy. And it looked bad. But I did hear from somebody there that they think this guy was just working because he was doing a job. So I don't know if that's the case or not, but since I haven't heard any update on Randy Orton today, I'm presuming the guy's all right. Not saying he was necessarily faking it, but hopefully he's all right. Let's just put it that way. Austin Theory with Vince. They're already building up this Pat McAfee show. Austin Theory says he's going to be there. So in case for some reason Pat McAfee just tries to attack Vince in the middle of an interview, because, you know, that happens all the time. Austin Theory is going to be there to save the day.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Finn Balor versus Damian Priest. Good match, 11 minutes. And I'm watching the match, and Finn Balor hits the dropkick in the corner. He starts going up top. I'm waiting for somebody to run in. I'm waiting for somebody to set something up for Finn Balor in WrestleMania. It didn't happen. He did the double foot stomp, and he pinned Priest in the middle of the ring, and he won the title. What? So then Damian Priest says, I'm going to win that belt back. And you know what? When I do, I'm not going to care about these fans. These fans have never given me the respect I have deserved. These fans never cheer. I'm like, what?
Turned into Loki there.
You know, someone made a comment. They were like, look at that MJF promo where he basically talked about his real life and his villain origin story and how incredible it was. And WWE's got one heel promo. It's not like they got, like, six heel promos and they, like, interlock them. So, like, okay, you're going to take this part and then this part, but take out. No, it's the same promo. No matter who you are, if you're a heel, it's those fans. The fans never gave me the respect I deserve. Like, bro. So, anyway, he's a heel now. And we had a heel turn. And what better way to follow up on a heel turn than another heel turn? Edge came out. Why does nobody want to face me at WrestleMania? Well, because the match is going to go 49 minutes and drag. So anyway, AJ Styles finally comes out. And they go face to face. And Edge offers a handshake. And then he boots him in the nards, as we used to call him in high school. And beats him down and then gives him two of the concertos. So it is Edge as a heel against AJ Styles as a babyface coming up at WrestleMania. If they don't go 46 minutes, if they like keep it at a reasonable time, like 16, 17 minutes, that match could be a show stealer. I'm begging you. Let's make this a show stealer. In this case, It is not a marathon. It's a sprint, okay? It's like the Stardom high speed title. Let's do it that way instead of the other way. You know what I'm saying? That's Raw, everybody. I have so much fun doing the Raw report. Can you tell? Oh, I have such a great time.
So it's
almost as much fun as I have doing cameos. F4W Online on Cameo, everybody.
So he lost a hair match. Came back with hair. We never saw him bald, and then decides to just shave his head. Do I have all this exactly right?
Yeah. Now he wants to have his head shaved.
Oh, pardon me. Yeah.
Vinny.
Yeah.
Vinny, stop that! No! God. Bro.
Trying to kill the brain cells necessary to tolerate the show.
If you enjoy these videos, for just $7.99 per month, you can enjoy full-length editions of The Bryan and Vinny Show, Wrestling Observer Live, Figure Four Daily with Tom Lawler and Lance Storm, The Mad Men Podcast, Speak Now Pro Wrestling with Denise Salcedo and more, plus hundreds of archived shows, all in beautiful HD. Don't miss out. Join us today.